not the nerve supply. Same like the arterial supply, it is the lateral wall of the nose, it is the nasal sac. Four quadrants. First of all, the spatial sensation. Spatial sensation means it is the olfactory sensation. It is carried by the olfactory epitheliums. The olfactory receptors are present and the olfactory nerves perforate the scabriform plate and enters the cranial cavity and joins the olfactory bulb. So, the upper region, above the superior concha, it is the spatial sensation carried by the olfactory nerve. Now the general sensation. General sensation means pain, touch, temperature. The anterosuperior quadrant. This is the anterosuperior quadrant. And it is supplied by the anterior ethmoidal nerve. The artery is the anterior ethmoidal artery. Nerve is the anterior ethmoidal nerve. Artery branch of the ophthalmic artery, it is the branch of the ophthalmic nerve. Ophthalmic nerve divided into three terminal branches. Frontal lacrimal nasociliary, it is the nasociliary. Branch of the nasociliary. Same on the nasal side. Now the anteroinferior quadrant. This anteroinferior quadrant, this nerve, it is the anterior superior alveolar nerve. The artery is the superior labial branch of the facial artery. Nerve, it is the anterior superior alveolar nerve. It is a branch of the maxillary nerve. And the same on the nasal sac. The same nerve, anterior superior alveolar nerve. Now the posterior superior and the posterior inferior, this region, either of the lateral wall of the nose or the nasal sac, it is supplied by the branch of the pterygoparatine ganglion. Pterygoparatine ganglion. This ganglion is situated in the pterygoparatine fossa. And its branches are distributed by the maxillary. So, its posterior superior quadrant, this region, it is supplied. In the case of the lateral wall, it is supplied by the lateral posterior superior nasal branch of the pterygoparatine ganglion. Because the lateral wall is situated laterally. The septum is situated medially, so it is the same. Medial, only change is the medial. Medial posterior superior nasal branch of the pterygoparatine ganglion. If you forget, say it is supplied by the branches of the pterygoparatine ganglion through the maxillary nerve. This posterior quadrant, either superior or inferior. The inferior, it is the nasoparatine, greater palatine branch of the pterygoparatine ganglion. From the pterygoparatine ganglion, it is the nasoparatine nerve and the greater palatine nerve. And they are distributed through the maxillary nerve and they supply this anteroinferior quadrant. So, if you forget the remember, you forget about the name of this nerve. You should remember it is the pterygoparatine ganglion that supplies this posterior quadrant region, either upper or below. And this is the anterior ethmoidal nerve and this is the anterior superior alveolar nerve. This is the nasal septum and this is the lateral wall of the nose. Now, after the spatial sensation, general sensation, there is also the mucosal glands are present in the nasal cavity. These glands have the secretomotor pathway and this secretomotor pathway, the postganglionic fibers of this pathway comes from the pterygoparatine ganglion. This pterygoparatine ganglion topographically related with the maxillary nerve. The pterygoparatine ganglion topographically it is related with the maxillary nerve. Maxillary nerve. It is hanged from the maxillary nerve by the two nerves. but the functionally. The preganglionic fibers for the nasal cavity secretion comes from the facial nerve. So this ganglion, retroparietal ganglion, functionally related with the seventh cranial nerve, that is the facial nerve. And if you remember, its fibers comes from the superior salivatory nucleus. Then there is a greater petrosal nerve and the deep petrosal nerve unite to form the nerve of pterygoid canal. Nerve of the pterygoid canal. And this nerve of the pterygoid canal, also known as the Wiedemann's nerve. Wiedemann's nerve. And this relay to the pterygoparatine ganglion. And from the ganglion, the postganglionic fibers arise and that is distributed through the maxillary nerve. So, the secretomotor pathway of these nasal glands, mucosal glands, comes related with the pterygoparatine ganglion and it comes from the facial nerve. Now, the venous supply. The venous supply of the nasal cavity anterior part drains into the facial vein, while the middle part it drains into the pterygoid venous plexus. Where this plexus is present? While the posterior part drains into the pharyngeal plexus of veins. The posterior part, that is towards the nasopharynx, drains into the pharyngeal plexus of the veins. So the venous drainage from this nasal cavity comes to these three regions. Now the lymphatics. The lymphatics from the anterior half of the nasal cavity drains into the submandibular group of the lymph nodes. These lymph nodes present in the submandibular region, embedded into the submandibular gland, while the posterior half it drains into the retropharyngeal group of the lymph nodes or upper deep cervical group of the lymph nodes. Upper deep cervical, that is the jugulodigastric group of the lymph nodes that are arranged around the internal jugular vein. So this is the venous canals, venous not supplied in the head. Venous drainage, and this is the lymphatic drainage of the nasal cavity. And this is about the nasal cavity. Now the one term, what is rhinoscopy? This is for you, think about the rhinoscopy. And so this is about the nasal cavity. The important parts of this nasal cavity is the lateral wall of the nose. It is very important. What is the concha and what is meatus? What are the openings in the meatus? Superior meatus, middle meatus, inferior meatus? They are frequently asked in the examination. And it is the nasal septum. The parts forming the nasal septum, bony and the cartilaginous part, and the Little's area, Kieselbeck's area, that is the most common region of epistaxis, and sometimes it is the blood supply of the nasal cavity. These are the topics that are frequently asked in the nasal cavity. Thank you very much.